This one will be 1, 2, and 3. 3-methylcyclohexene. 3-methylcyclohexene. Yeah. Okay. Methylcyclohexene. Then the second one is, which of the following is not accordance to the IUPAC system? There you have 1-bromo-prop-2-ene. This is correct. You have this one, A1. This will be 1-bromo. Ah, yeah, yeah. This will be 3-bromo. Yeah, correct. This is also fine. Third one, for the given alkene, you have to give the IUPAC nomenclature. The IUPAC nomenclature for this given alkene will be this is the, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So nonane, it is correct. Then you have 1 ethyl group in, okay, this is 2, this is, yeah, fine. So 6-ethyl, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-ethyl, 2-methyl, nonane. Yeah, correct, this is correct. Fourth one, the IUPAC compound name, okay. How will you name this one? Achha, did you not get any idea with the options? Yes, Parvati?
No, sir. I'm not sure.
You're not sure. Okay. So you have 1-bromine here. Another bromine is here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 6. So there are 2 cyclic rings, right? There are 2 cyclic rings. That means what we can say is it is dicyclo. And okay, just leave this question because I have not told you about this bicyclic compounds in which you have 2 cyclic compounds fused together. Okay, so when this will come in, this will come in alkenes, and I will tell you how to name these things where you have 1' and 2' things. Okay, I should have taken care of this. Okay, now question number 5 is I can't see the full question, so let me draw it here. This is Br, chlorine, C double bond C, chlorine and iodine, nothing else, right? Nothing else. First of all, the functional group is E, unsaturation is En. This will be the parent. So what do we have here? This will be the parent, right? So we have, is there any other case which can be parent? No. No. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 2 options with 4-bromo. Okay, fine. 4-bromo. And this is 2-chloromethyl, yeah, correct. 4-bromo, 2-chloromethyl, 1-fluoro, 1-iodo-but-1-ene. Okay. We will discuss this, okay? So yours is correct. Who else? I think. Let me see, Maimuna's. This will be 3-methyl, no? 3-methyl. Okay. This will be 3-methylcyclohexene. 3-methylcyclohexene. Okay. What else? 1-bromo-prop-1-ene. Okay. I think this is correct. 6-ethyl-nonane. Correct. 4,4-dibromo to hai nahi na usme in the last question. Okay, this is fourth one. Okay, we will discuss this. Fifth one, I have given the answer. Okay, in the Parvati's assignment. The answer here is A, na Parvati? 4-bromo?
No, B, sir.
B, okay. Who else? Mazia. Minashi ke do do hain. This one is old one. This is the new one. Again, I think this is not right. Option will be A here. For the second one, C1 is C is correct, okay? C is correct. A is not right. A is not right. So here the option is A. Then in the third question, 4-ethyl, no. This is again 6-ethyl-2-methyl, no, no, B. We will discuss this. And again, no. Mazia, you need to see, okay? This is option B. Who else? Do we have anyone else? Minashi, you have not submitted assignment, I guess.
No, sir, I didn't.
You did not, okay. What about Razan? You also did not, no? Razan?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, what happened? Are you guys busy? You don't even have school nowadays, no? Do you have school?
No, sir.
No school, no? Then what happened?
Last chances, I didn't get third in supplement.
Okay. But please start doing assignments, okay? There are not many questions, but do it. You get some gaps, na? Yeah. Thursday was class, and then you have on Tuesday. Yeah, there was much gap. Okay, 28th December. What's the day? Tuesday. Okay. So, in today's class, we are going to start alkanes. Okay, we are going to start alkanes. Acha. Did we do any classifications of organic compounds? Yes or no? Let me see the first class. There only I may have given you the classification. If not, then I can give it now. Yeah, I think I have not given you the classification of organic compounds. I can give it to you. You can write with. Hydrocarbons, right? So we will be classifying hydrocarbons, first of all, hydrocarbons. There are three major classifications of hydrocarbons, and we are going to learn all of these in this lesson, okay? We are going to learn all of these. First one is saturated, unsaturated, and here you have aromatic. Okay, aromatic. Now inside saturated molecules, inside saturated hydrocarbons, it has only, it contains only carbon-carbon single bonds. Okay, so example will be all types of alkanes. Now in unsaturated one, the unsaturated one, here there can be, here there can be carbon-carbon multiple bond. Carbon-carbon multiple bond, okay? So this would be containing alkene and alkynes. Alkenes and alkynes. Okay. Now, both of these, saturated and unsaturated, it can also contain cyclic alkanes, cyclic alkenes, cyclic alkynes, okay? All of these things. Not alkyne, by the way. Only cyclic alkenes and cyclic alkenes. Now, in aromatic, we'll have benzene, and its derivatives. Okay, so this particular fragment is a must in aromatic molecules. Okay, this fragment is a must, and then you can have different substituent attached to it. Here alkanes means cyclic alkanes will also be present. Okay, right, cyclic alkanes also. Cyclic alkane. Here you can write cyclic alkene. Done, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So first, we will start studying alkanes. And in the alkanes only, we will be studying cyclic alkanes, okay? So we will start with alkanes. So please write alkane. First topic, alkanes. Okay. What are alkanes, guys? Can somebody tell me? You must have seen alkanes in 10th standard, no? As for the definition, you can just define. These are what? These
single
are?
Single bonded carbon atoms.
Yeah, single bonded carbon atoms, right? So these are hydrocarbons. First of all, hydrocarbon. What does that mean? It will contain only hydrogen and only carbons. Only hydrogens and carbon. So please write with me. These are saturated hydrocarbons that contain only carbon single bonds. Okay, these are also known as, this is important, paraffins. Okay, paraffins. Now paraffins is derived from Latin word which means param. It means little. And affin. There is another word which is affin, which is derived from affinis. It means affinity. Why was this name given paraffin? Because alkanes, they have very low reactivity. Alkanes have low reactivity. Low reactivity. Acha, can somebody explain me this word here, saturated? What is the meaning of saturated in general?
When no more can be mixed in it.
Nothing. I mean, saturation means the point after which nothing can happen, right? You cannot add any more. So what cannot be added anymore in alkanes? And why do we call this saturated hydrocarbons? How guys, tell me. Acha. If I have one carbon atom, then one carbon atom can have maximum how many hydrogen atoms? Maximum how many?
Four.
Okay. But if we have two carbon atoms, then Eight. Arey bhai bhai, nahi. Two carbon atoms like this. Like this na, in a molecule.
Six.
How many?
Six.
Six, right? If I have three carbon atoms, then?
Nine.
Nine kaise hoga?
Eight.
Eight, right? Yeah. So it means that if I have one carbon atom, I cannot have more than four. Similarly, if I have two carbon atoms, I cannot have more than six. And if I have three carbon atoms, I cannot have more than eight. Okay. That is why saturation here, saturated means that the number of hydrogen is saturated in alkanes. You cannot add more hydrogen. But if I compare alkanes with alkenes, then you know if it is an alkene, it will have C2H4. Yes or no? Yes or no, guys? And if I have alkyne, then it will be C2H2. So as you can see, you can add more hydrogens to the alkyne and you will get alkene, and you can still add more hydrogens to alkene and you will get alkanes. But after alkenes, you cannot add any more hydrogen. That is why this word saturated. Okay. That is why this word saturated. All of you understand now? What is the meaning of saturated here? What is saturated? The number of hydrogen is saturated. Okay. The number of hydrogen is saturated. That is why these are known as saturated hydrocarbons. Then, now let us look at the structure of alkenes. Let us write some example. Then we can draw the structure. So, okay, for alkenes, you can see there are two types. One is open chain alkenes, which have a general formula. What will be the general formula? CnH2n+2. For example, you will have CH4, C2H6, C3H8, and what you can have, C4H will be how much? C4H10.
Okay.
If one carbon is there, it is known as methane. This molecule is known as methane. This is known as ethane, right? As you can see now, E-A-N and eth, this will be prop, A-N-E, this will be bute, A-N-E. Okay, so these are examples of what? These are examples of open chain alkenes. Done. Now you can write. Second type of alkanes are cyclic alkanes or cycloalkanes. Cyclic alkanes or cycloalkanes. What is the general formula for this? The general formula for this is CnH2n. Okay, CnH2n. Now the simplest cycloalkane that you can form is with CH2 bonded to CH2. Okay, this can also be written as, what is this? This is cyclopropane. Okay, Mazia, sorry. Yeah, please write this.
Done, sir.
Done? Okay. You can also have cyclobutane. This is cyclopentane. This is cyclohexane. Can I move?
Yes, sir.
Now, write structure of alkenes. And these are old informations, okay? Structure of alkenes. Now, we have already studied methane in which chapter? We studied methane in chemical bonding chapter, right? And we know that if I have methane, then the hybridization is what? First of all, let us talk about steric number. Steric number is? Steric number will be 4. Achha, how many of you know this concept of steric number? Razan, you did chemical bonding with us or no? Razan, I think Parvati has not done chemical bonding with me. I also don't think, Maimuna, you have done chemical bonding with me or no?
No, sir, I think so.
No, na? Razan, you also know? Razan, it's done, I think. Yes, Razan, are you there?
Yes, sir.
You have done, na? Okay, so steric number is nothing. I mean, in organic chemistry, in organic chemistry or either in the chemical bonding chapter, steric number is nothing but it is the sum of bonds plus lone pair. Okay, and rather sigma bonds plus lone pair, I would say. Sum of sigma bonds plus lone pair. Okay, so steric number of all the carbon atom in a particular alkene will be 4 only, because the carbon atom will be joined with another carbon atom and the other valencies will be fulfilled by hydrogens. Okay, so this will be always steric number will be 4. If the steric number is 4, then the hybridization will be sp3 for all of these carbon atoms. Now, if the hybridization is sp3, then angle I can say is what the angle will be. Okay, after hybridization, I can give you the electronic geometry. This will be tetrahedral. After that, you will have shape. Shape will be also tetrahedral. Now you can write the angle. The angle will be 109.5 degrees. 109.5 degrees, okay? Now, this is shown as, now you will see a wedge type of thing. And there will be a dash type of thing, which is used to show the three-dimensional structure. So if I have a wedge, it means that this is coming out. And this one is going in. Okay. This one is going in. All of you understand now, if I say what, when it is going in and when it is coming out, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
What about others? Does anyone has any problem with that? Please let me know, okay?
So can you explain that?
Yeah. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this, we have, this is the carbon atom. Achha, can you see that these two are in one plane? Can you see that?
Yes,
or maybe if I will rotate it a bit more. Now this in one plane, that means if I draw a triangle, Anna?
Yeah.
Anna, I can draw a triangle. It means that if you have 3 points, that means you can draw a triangle, and triangle is a what? It is a planar structure, right? So can I say that this particular hydrogen atom, this carbon atom here, and this hydrogen atom, these are in one plane? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what do you think about this hydrogen atom here? Is this hydrogen atom, it is away from the plane? I mean, is it before that plane or it is after that plane? This hydrogen atom, what does it seem?
Before the plane.
Before that plane. What about this hydrogen atom, which is here?
Behind the plane.
Behind. Okay. I think everyone must. Okay. Is there any still any doubt? Tell me.
Yes.
No, sir.
No, no. So all of you can see. Okay. So you have to keep all these three in one plane. This carbon here, this hydrogen, and this hydrogen. And then you will have this in one plane. One will be pointing outwards. The other will be behind it. The other will be behind it. Okay. So all of the carbon atoms which will be present in alkane will have this hybridization. This is important. Okay. So you remember this one. This part here. That all the carbon atom in an alkane, if it has four bonds, that means if it has four sigma bonds, okay, it will be sp3 hybridized. It will be sp3 hybridized. Okay. Next, we have nomenclature of alkane, but I don't think you need it. Let me just give you a few examples so that you at least know how the questions are given in NCERT. Okay, right? The name, or rather IUPAC name. Of following. So we have done all our study in the bond line structure, okay? But you may not get bond line structure in the examination. Things will be like this, CH3, whole four, and then there is carbon. So what does this mean? That this carbon is attached to four molecules of, you can see now, you have seen like this now, H4C. What does this mean? It means that this carbon is attached to four hydrogens. Similarly, what does it mean here? It means that this carbon is attached to four CH3 molecules. So it's like this, CH3, 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 and CH3. Okay, try naming this. Yes, Parvati, correct. I'm waiting for others. Please start with functional group. Then you will have the, after functional group, you will have unsaturation. Then you will have the parent, okay? And after that, you will have the substituent, whatever is left. Yes, Maimuna, correct. So if I start with functional group, this will be E. Unsaturation will be AN, all single bonds. Yes, Razan, very good, correct. then you will have parent. So terminal to terminal, you can choose this one. Yes, Khalil, very good, correct. Parent will be prop, and then you have substituent. So there are two substituents. One is methyl. The other is also methyl. So you can write it them as dimethyl. If I want to number it, 1, 2, 3. So this will be 2, 2. So I will start from here. 2, 2. Dimethyl. Prop. In. Okay. So this is important that you have a dash between 2, 2. Okay. I see, Razan, you have not placed the dash there. Okay. So keep track of these things, that numbers are separated by comma, number and letter are separated by a dash. Okay. Write B part. Write B part. Let us suppose you have CH3. Just given something like this. CH3 hold twice. Then you have a carbon atom. This carbon atom, they have told that it is attached to C2H5. Okay. And this carbon atom, then it is attached to CH2. Then a carbon atom and then CH3 hold thrice. So most problem you will be having will be from converting from this condensed structure to the bottling structure, but don't worry. So whatever is not in brackets, you write them first, okay, as it is. So you have C2H5. Whatever is not in brackets, you write them first, C2H5. Then this carbon is attached to CH2. Then this carbon is attached to carbon. As you can already see, now, if you want to fulfill the valency of this carbon, you have to attach two CH3 groups like this. CH3. And if you have to fulfill the valency of this particular carbon, then you have to keep three CH3s. Okay. Now you can start naming it. Right. Functional group is E and saturation is AN. You have to identify the parent and the substituent. Give me the parent, okay? If you identify the parent, give me the parent. Yes, correct, correct, Parvati. Yeah, yes, Sayyid Muhammad, very good. Now you can also identify the substituent, okay? Identify the substituent. No, Minashi, try again. Identify from terminal to terminal. Okay, identify the terminals. No, Mamuna, identify the terminals. So I can write this as CH3 with a carbon, CH2, then again a carbon like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons, and then again here. CH3 here, CH3 here. Then this carbon has one carbon here, and let us say one carbon here. Okay. So identify the terminals and then start.
So there's one more CH3 on.
One more CH3 is there.
Yeah.
One more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No, sir, on the second carbon.
Second carbon, yeah. Okay. I hope you have written the question. Let me give another question to those who have already done this. Right, CH3. This is bonded to a carbon, which is bonded to two methyl groups, CH3, CH3. This again is bonded to a carbon atom, which is bonded to 3 CH3s. This carbon atom is bonded to 3 CH3s. Okay. Then you have this carbon atom. Let us suppose that this is bonded to CH3, CH3, and CH3. Yes, Razan, correct now. Razan is correct. Waiting for Minashi and Maimuna to change their answer. Minashi and Maimuna, you still think it is pent? Yes, Minashi, Maimuna?
No, sir.
No.
No? Okay, then what is the parent? What is the parent then? If not pent? Tell me. Minashi, Maimuna, what happened? Maimuna, can you please send the mic on?
Yes, sir.
How many terminals are there? How many terminals are there?
6.
Let me see. A, B, C, D, E, and F. Where should I start from? Where should I start from? Can you please repeat that?
B.
D. Why D?
B. B.
Why D?
B. Is sir.
D have? Ha, you are talking about D, na?
No. B.
B. B. Why B? B. Why B? Why B? Tell me. Please see na, which of them has more number of carbon atoms, like before any junction. If I start with B, I will move only one bond and I will get a junction. Same with A, same with C, same with D, same with F. But can you see that if I start with F, then I will have more number of carbon atoms now. So yes. The parent is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. Substituent is all methyls. How many methyls? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 methyls. And let me start. I will start from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this will be 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl. Okay, tetramethyl hexane. So the name will be 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl hexane. Okay. Yeah, do this one, the C one. Don't worry, okay? This is easy only. So we have learned about these, na, isobutyl and all. Okay, fine. Correct. Yes, Parvati, that is correct. Yes, correct. Till now it is correct. You just need to identify the substituents now. Okay, so see, can all of you tell me what is the functional group here? What should I write for the functional group? Please tell me what happened, guys. Maimuna, Mazia, Mehreen, Minashi, tell me for functional group what should I write? Khalil,
E.
Unsaturation.
An.
Now parent. Okay. For parent, you have to wait. You will not see that there are how many. So you will not start like this. A, B, C. These A, B, and C, all of them are same. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Repent.
Hai na? A. Then you have B, C, and D. Now you take any of them. You take any of them. You will have 5 carbons only. If you start with any of them, you will have 5 carbons only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Even if you start with B, you will have 5 carbons. Even if you start with C or D. Okay. They are all the same. So the next is parent is pent. Now, whatever remains, what is remaining? You know these things, right? These are methyls. So there is 4 methyl. Huh? There are 4 methyl. So either you start with here or here, it is same thing. So you will have 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl. Then you have this fragment here. And here you have this fragment here. How many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons here, 4 carbons here. Okay. That means obviously in the 1, 2, 3rd position, 3, 3, you have di. There is some butyl. This is tert butyl. If you remember, this is tert butyl. Okay, this is tert butyl. Now we have M here and we have B here. Okay, the tetra, it is only for what? The tetra is only for. And also one more thing. If I write tert butyl, it will be written like this. Di. Tert butyl. Tert is also a number only, no? That is right. Di. Tert. Butyl. Okay, di tert butyl. Here we have B, here we have M. So B will come first, and hence the name will be 3, 3 di tert butyl. Then you have 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl pentane. Write this down. Let me know if you're done. write this down, guys. Let me know if you're done. Done? Done. Can I move on? Yes or no? Okay. No, right? Isomerism in alkenes. Isomerism in alkene. Isomerism in alkene. Okay. Fine. So, you guys know something about isomerism? From classification of organic molecules? No, I don't think so. Isomerism in alkene, okay? So please write here, in isomerism of alkene. Alkenes show structural isomerism. How many of you are hearing this isomerism word for the first time? Tell me. Is there anyone who is hearing this isomerism for the first time? Because we have started with the second term before doing the classification. Organic chemistry. Some basic concepts and techniques. So, all of you know isomerism?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And so I'm thinking that all of you know isomerism, okay? Simply defined, it is same molecule formula, but different structural formula. Same molecular formula, but different structural formula, okay? Alkenes show structural isomerism in which the isomers differs in their chain or skeleton. Differs in their chain or skeleton. Okay. Now, if I start with the first member of alkene, what is the first member of alkene? CH4. Okay. Now, for CH4, I cannot arrange it. I cannot change the chain here. I cannot change the chain here. Similarly, if I go for C2H6, okay, that means CH3. Here also, I cannot change the chain. Similarly, if I go for CH2, CH3, I cannot change the chain here, okay? I cannot change the chain because even if I take this particular CH3, the CH3 molecule, and I want to put it somewhere else, I have no other carbon except this carbon here. Okay. Similarly, here also, if I want to move this anywhere, I have two carbon atoms. Either I can move it to this carbon atom, CH2, which is already present, or I can move this to CH3. Now, as soon as I move this to CH3, the previous CH3, it will become CH2. Okay. So these three will not have any isomers. Now, if I move to CH4, that means C4. So we have four carbons here. Okay. And all these have two hydrogens. Okay. Now what I can do, if I place this carbon atom and I place it like this, if I change the chain like this. Now, if you compare these two, the formula for this will be, there are C4, H is how much? 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. C4, H10. Here also, C is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 3, 9 plus 1, 10. C4, H10. So the molecular formula is same. But as you can see, the structural formula is different, right? And what is changing here? The main chain is changing here. If I want to write the name, you will see that there is a difference in the main chain. There's a difference in the main chain. Now this will be named as simple butane. But this will be named as 1, 2, 3. That means it is prop and there is one methyne. This is 2-methyne propane. Okay. So as you can see, there are 4 carbons in the main chain, and here there are 3 carbons in the main chain. Write this example. Let me know if you're done. Please tell me if you don't understand, then I will go into some more details of isomerism. Okay. I will ask you some questions and then I can go to some more details. Done, all of you?
1 second. Done.
More or done? You want me to
done,
scroll?
Sir.
Done. Okay. Now you can also have some isomers in pentane. So pentane has 5 carbon atoms. So I can draw pentane like this. Okay. This is one structure, which is pentane. If I take this one carbon atom and I will put it here to the next carbon atom, then I will get, so this carbon atom, I am putting it here, right? Now you can see this was the main chain. Now the main chain has changed and this is the main chain. Similarly, the name will also change. Now this is methyl group. It is attached on the second carbon. So this will be 2-methyl butane. Now I can again do one thing, that I will take this methyl and I can shift it here. Okay. So let us see what happens if I move that methane there. So you will see that it is again, there is butane, and in the second carbon, you have methyl. That means these two structures are same, right? These two structures are same. These are not isomers. Okay. These two structures are same. So also 2-methyl. Butane. But rather, what you can do to get a new structure for pentane, what you can do is you can take this carbon atom, and place it in the middle. Okay. So you have 3 in the chain. There is one carbon atom here, there's another carbon atom here. Now this is named as what? This will be named as 2,2 dimethyl propane. Okay. So pentane has how many? Pentane has 3 isomers. Pentane has 3 isomers. Done, guys?
Yes.
Done for pentane? Okay. So now I will write list. Here I will write number of carbons in alkane, or rather I should just write alkane. Here I will write number of isomers. So if you have CH4, it has 0 isomer. Similarly, C2H6, 0 isomer. C3H8, 0 isomer. C4H10, 2 isomer. C5H12, 3 isomer. If you have C6H, will be how much? It will be 14, right? It has 5. Then if you go to C7, then how much will be 8? H will be 16, right? 14 plus 2, yeah. Now this has 9, I guess. Yeah, it has 9 only, yeah. Then if you go to C8, H18, this has 18 isomers. If you go to C9, H will be how much? 20, right? I don't remember actually this one. You write for C10, H22, it has 75. So somewhere around 49, 50, I guess. C9, H. Is it fine?
Yes.
So you have to know at least all these structures till pentane, okay? You can do homework for C6H14. You can try making 5 isomers from there. Done? Let me know, guys, if you're done.
Done.
All right. Classification of carbon atoms in alkene. Okay, classification of carbon atoms in alkene. So the carbon atom, it can be classified into 4 different groups. Okay, it can be classified into 4 different groups. One is known as primary, secondary, it will be 3 only, no? Primary, secondary, I made 5, sorry. Primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. Quaternary. Primary is also known as 1 degree. Secondary is known as 2 degree. Tertiary is known as 3 degree. Quaternary is known as 4 degree carbon. Okay. Write four points, the carbon attached to only one carbon, then it is known as primary carbon or 1 degree carbon. Okay, primary carbon or 1 degree carbon. Similarly, a carbon attached to 2 carbons in a chain, it will be known as secondary or 2 degree carbon. A carbon attached to 3 carbons will be known as tertiary carbon or 3 degree carbon. Similarly, a carbon attached to 4 carbons will be known as quaternary or 4 degree carbon. Done, guys? Let me know if you're done, okay?
Done.
All of you done?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Now write a question. Write a question. Assign 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, and 4 degree. To each carbon, okay, 1 degree or 2 degree or 2, 3 degree, 3 degree or 4 degree, okay, to each carbon in following structures. In following structures. So, right, A, CH3, CH2, C, CH, CH3. CH3. Let's give this CH3, and this is also CH3. Okay, this is one structure. Right, B part CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Right, the C structure. CH3, CH, CH, CH3. CH3N, CH3. What else you can write? CH3, C, CH2, CH3, CH3, CH3. In these four, you have to assign like this, okay? I'm doing for some. For example, this is 1 degree, right? And this is also 1 degree, okay? So like this, you have to assign. This is 2 degree, this is 3 degree, okay? So in this way, you have to assign in all of the carbon atoms. Then you will click a photo of that and send it to Niskarsar on WhatsApp, okay? After you are done, let me give you 2-3 minutes, then I will ask you. When you are done, you click a photo, send it to Niskarsar. And also, please write a name in your notebook, okay? That name should be present if you're clicking the photo. Asya has sent the answer. Yeah, the Muhammad has given all the like a PDF and all. Okay. 1, 2, 4, 1, 1, 3, 1. Correct. 1, 2, 2, 1. Correct. 1, 3, 3, 1. Correct. 1, 1. Correct. 1, 4, 2, 1, 1. Correct. Yeah. Where did you send Mazia?
Finish person.
Okay. Anyone else who has sent?
So should I send it through Zoom?
Can you send in the chat to me?
Yes.
If you can send it, then send it to me in the chat only. Minashi has also, Khalil has also sent. Wait a second, okay? I'm sending you a number. You send it to that number, okay? 7, 8. Save this number and send it to this number. No? Yeah, I have time. Okay, Maimuna has sent it here only. One, two, one, four, three. One, yeah, correct. 1, 2, 2, 1. Okay. 1, correct, 3, 3, correct, 3, correct, 1, correct, okay. Yeah, I think all of you are doing it right. So let me write the answers, okay? This will be 2 degrees. This will be 4 degrees. 1 degree. 1 degree. 1 degree. 3 degree. 1 degree. 1 degree. 2 degree. 1 degree. Okay, one more answer. Mazia has sent it here. Let me see Mazia's answer. Yeah, 1, 2, 1, 4, 1, 3, 1, 1, correct. 1, 2, 2, 2, 1, correct. 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, correct. 1, 4, 1, 1, 2, 1, correct. Yeah, correct, correct. Okay. This is also 1 degree. This is 3 degrees. This is 1 degree. 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 This is 2 degree. This is 1 degree and this is 4 degree. Okay. So all of you. Okay, I have got me. Okay.
ये ब्लू ब्लू पेज में कौन लिखता है?
Who is this in blue page? Huh? Ah, seems like you are not writing. Who is this with blue page? Na, they have not written their name. Are you tell me? Don't. Who is that? You can't unmute. So are you not writing notes? It seems like you have just taken some sheet and you have written the question and answer. Huh? It seems like that only. You're not writing notes, Abdurrahman? Seems you're not taking notes. Okay. So you're done. You're done with this. Now I will ask you one question. What is the correct order of boiling point? Boiling point should I take or should I take anything else? Boiling point. Of the three isomer pentane. Option A. Pentane has highest, and you have 2-methylbutane. It 2,2 dimethyl propane. You can just reverse this option. Pentane 2,2 dimethyl propane. Two methyl butane. And D. None of these. Okay. So write this question and tell me if you're stuck or you are not stuck or you're trying to do something. You must be thinking that we have not learned about boiling point of alkanes, but we have learned some things in an earlier chapter that will help you in answering this question. So Minashi, Parvati, Razan, all of you will tell me, okay, if you're done writing. Okay, Parvati has answered me. Can you explain your answer, Parvati?
So 2,2 dimethyl propane contains tertiary carbon, which is more stable. It's more stable.
More stable. Why? Why more stable?
We have learned. I'm not sure. This is a guess.
Achha. Achha, okay, one more thing. So whatever you are, I mean, even if it is, let us say if it is stable, okay? Let us say that is stable. So whatever you are talking about stability, it is for a molecule, na? For one molecule, right?
Yes.
inside a molecule, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But boiling point, it is a molecular property or a bulk property?
Bulk property.
Now, do you think even if it is, let us suppose that it is more stable, then do you think it will, I mean, affect the boiling point? No, na?
No.
No. Okay. Think, okay? Okay, now, okay. I will try to give you some hint. Think what is the criteria for a high boiling point or low boiling point? Okay, think in those terms. What affects the boiling point? What affects the boiling point? Think in those terms. Khalil, what do you think? What will affect the boiling point?
The surface area.
Okay, elaborate. Not directly, na, but I mean, go to the first principle kind of thing. Like basically, like at the core, what determines the boiling point? If there is high boiling point, then what can we say regarding the molecules? What is more, what is less?
Is it because of the geometry?
Maimuna has given an answer. Maimuna, can you explain the answer? And can you tell me which chapter is helping you to give this answer? Or you learned it somewhere? Yes, Maimuna, can you unmute yourself?
Yes, sir. According to me, it's option A because in my school, the sir taught
us that if... No, ho gaya. In my school, sir taught us. Apne se bataiye aap. We have done this.
We did this in states of matter.
Okay, fine. Now you are going in the right track. Okay. Does anyone remember? Can anyone link this question to states of matter? Which lecture? First lecture only, na? Maimuna?
Yes, sir.
Hana, first lecture only. Parvati, were you with us in states of matter?
No,
you
sir.
Were there, na? No, yeah. You were not there? Oh, sad. What about others? Razan was there. Razan? Razan padhna band kar chuki hai lekin, hai na? Yes, Razan, are you studying? Razan? Yeah. Are you studying? Do you remember? No, na? Khalil, what about you?
Yes, sir.
You remember, right? So what will be the correct option? You can flip your pages. You can go back to the chapter states of matter in the first lecture and you can look at those things. Maybe it will refresh your mind. What happened? Khalil, Maimuna has given. Mazia, do you remember or no? No. So I think, don't remember. Yeah, Khalil, correct. States of matter, first lecture. Do you remember now? Ha, Maimuna, Mazia, Shoaib, not Mehreen, Minashi, Razan.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
So if the intermolecular forces will decrease, what will happen? The boiling point will also decrease. Okay. So what you can do? Now here you need to draw the figures. Okay. Now this is a question on the boiling point order, but it is also an indirect question on the nomenclature, because if someone does not know how to make a structure from the needs, they will not be able to do it. This is pentane. This is 2-methylbutane. This is propane. Okay. Now if I am going, let me say this is A, B, and C. Then I can only tell the order of branching. Okay. Please remember, I can only tell the order of branching first. So branching is increasing like this. Okay. And I know that the intermolecular forces of attraction, it is what it is, inversely proportional, right? It is inversely proportional to branching. Hence, the intermolecular forces of attraction order will be directly proportional to boiling point. It means if the intermolecular forces of attraction are high, the boiling point will be high. That is why the order for boiling point will be, okay. So please, initially, you can't see and tell the boiling point. You can only see and tell the branching. So please write this first off, okay. Maybe you don't write this intermolecular force of attraction directly, but you will please write this branching, and only then you will be able to tell the boiling point order. Okay. Right. Now I can move on to the part where we will study the preparation of alkenes. Okay. Preparation of alkenes. So please write this, everyone. I can also write a note here. Intermolecular forces it is inversely proportional to branching. And melting point and boiling points is directly proportional to intermolecular forces. Write this down. Let me know if you're done. All right, preparation of alkenes. So we'll look at a few methods of the preparation of alkene, method of preparation of alkene. The first method is from unsaturated. Hydrocarbons. Okay. From unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay. Now in hydrocarbons, for unsaturated hydrocarbons, what we will be having, we will be having double bonds, and in that double bond we will be adding hydrogens, right? We will be adding hydrogens. So this method is also known as, this method is known as hydrogenation. This method is known as hydrogenation. Okay. Now, please write some examples. We will have some group R. Let me write it like this first. CH2, double bond CH2. then we will put, so let me add hydrogen here. We will be using some catalyst. These catalysts will be PD or platinum, or it will be rani nickel. Okay, so these three will be used. These three will be used, and we will be making alkenes. So you will be getting CH3. Okay. You can write a generalized form. R group is attached here, plus H2 in term in with, let us say, PD we are taking. So there is R. Here you will have H attached. Here you will have H attached like this. Okay. So this is what? This is addition. What we are doing? We are adding hydrogen to alkene. If I have, let us suppose if I have alkyne here, so I can show alkyne with carbon, triple bond carbon and R group. If I give only one mole of hydrogen, then it will be not sufficient, because if I give only one mole, it will be getting converted only to what? Only to alkene. So I have to give here 2 moles of H2. And this will give me hydrogen. Okay. It's a one thing more. These are the hydrogen which we have added. There will be one more hydrogen present here. Okay. There will be other hydrogens present here. So these are the hydrogens that we have added. And in alkyne, all the 4 hydrogens which have been added across the triple bond are the hydrogen added from the reaction. Write this down. Let me know if you're done. Done, guys?
Yes.
All of you done? Now, let me tell you how this particular reaction, these reactions happen, okay? So what you have is very finely divided. Please don't write these things, okay? So you have metal here, right? You have either PD, PT, or nickel. So let us take one of these metals. Let us say this is the palladium metal. Okay, this is palladium metal. And this palladium metal will be not like a surface, like a box. It will be very fine particles of palladium metal will be there. Palladium. Okay. So can you tell me what is the property of metal? Metal has the tendency to lose electron, right? Metal has the tendency to lose electron. So obviously there will be electron density here and there. So what will happen? These will attract the alkenes, which will be having pi bond like this. So you have C, double bond C. It will be captured by, so many C double bond C will be captured by these metals like this. Okay. Now, there will be hydrogens here. I'm not writing the hydrogens. Then what will happen? We will pass H2 gas. Okay, so hydrogen, they will slowly bond with these carbons. Okay, and then what you will be seeing, that this pi bond is breaking and you are getting alkenes as a result. And you get alkenes as a result. Alkene as a result. Okay, don't need to write this part, okay? Rather write a remark. Write some remark. Since metal catalysts, what are catalysts? Catalyst is anything that will faster a particular reaction. Okay, so those who have biology, they can say that it works like enzymes. So enzymes, they help in processes, right? So if catalyst, it helps in reactions. Since metal catalyst is used for hydrogenation, for hydrogenation of alkene and alkynes, for the preparation of for the preparation of alkenes, this method is also known as catalytic hydrogenation. Catalytic hydrogenation. One of the limitations of this particular method is what? Limitation. The important limitation is that CH4 cannot be prepared, right? Methane. Cannot be prepared by this method. Let me know if I need to explain this part, why methane cannot be prepared by this method. Okay. Is there anyone who understood this point, that methane cannot be prepared by this method? Why?
There's no C bonds.
For methane, we need what? We need an alkene or alkyne of one carbon, right? But there is no alkene or alkyne with only one carbon, right? So I hope this is clear with everyone now. Yes, Khalil, Maimuna, Mazia?
Yes.
Yes, sir. For methane, we need one carbon and we cannot have alkene or alkyne with only one carbon. Let me know if you're done.
And
draw the products. For following reactions.
So we're not writing plus H2.
Sorry. Thanks for reminding me.
Let me know when you're done.
Then we'll do one more
preparation. Then we can end it for today. Done, guys, yes or no?
Yes.
So these are easy questions, okay? So you will have just have to make alkane CH3, CH2, CH3, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, CH3, CH2, CH. CH3, CH2, CH3. Okay. Nothing much here. Done? All of you done? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, write the next preparation from alkyne halides. Second one is from. From alkyne halides. Okay. You know what are alkyne halides? First, let us write alkyne halide. What are alkyne halides? Rx. Okay.
These are
Rx. That means you have alkyl group. Alkyl group attached to a halogen. Attached to a halogen. In this, we have one method which is known as Wood's reaction. Which is used in the preparation of alkenes from alkyl group. But the reaction goes like this. You will have an alkyne halide Rx plus you will have sodium and you will make a molecule RR. Okay. Now to balance this, I will have to write 2 plus I will write 2 here and I will write 2 NaX. Now this will be balanced, okay? Write this, then we can understand this reaction. Write this, let me know when you're done.
Done, sir.
All of you done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us see what happens, okay? Now, there are basically two mechanism which is proposed. I will be going with the free radical one. Do you guys know about these terms? Homolytic cleavage, homolytic fission, and heterolytic fission. Yes or no? Tell me now. Is there anyone who has not even heard of these two terms, homolytic fission and heterolytic fission? Is there anyone, Mehreen? Have you heard of this homolytic heterolytic? Mehreen is not here. Khalil, what about you? Have you heard about this homolytic heterolytic?
Yes, sir.
So you have heard. What about Minashi, Masya? You guys have heard about this homolytic cleavage and heterolytic? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Okay, don't worry if you don't remember it. I'm just asking if you have heard this or not. Okay, if you have heard this or not. So this mechanism we will do using formation of an intermediate free radical.
Now let us take an example of CH3. CH2 Br. And there is one sodium atom here. Initially, what happens? These bonds break, okay, and you get to start with here. Wait a second. First of all, what will happen?
Sodium is there, right? Sodium is there.
Sodium will give an electron. Okay, and it will become sodium free radical. Okay, it will give an electron like this. Now you have CH3, CH2, Br. Okay, and then you have Na. Now one electron here, and you will get CH3, CH2. There will be a free radical here, plus Na, which had a positive charge, it will be Na, and Br with an electron, it will come and it will form NaBr. Okay, it will form NaBr. Now you have this CH2 free radical. What will happen now? CH3, CH2 free radical. And then you have, if this will happen two times, you will get two of these free radicals, and you will have CH2 free radical, CH3 free radical. Okay, CH2 free radical, CH2 free radical. This step, it will happen two times, and then you can form a bond like this. Get CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Okay, so we started with two carbon atoms of alkyne halide, and in the alkane we are getting, and in the alkene we are getting four carbons. Okay, the alkane of four carbons. So this is the result that is important, and you can remember this reaction like this. You have Rx plus 2Na plus, you can write XR. You take this thing together and you make the bond from here and here. RR plus 2NaX. For more examples, you can write CH3I plus 2Na plus 2Na. Then I can write here I CH3. Take this away, you will have CH3 plus 2NaI. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now write a note. Okay. Let me write what happens here. Okay. So when alkyne halide, is treated with sodium metal in presence of dry ether, leads to the formation of alkenes with double the number of carbon atoms. Okay, double the number of carbon atoms. Done? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, write remarks. Only alkenes with even number of carbon atoms can be formed by this method. Can be formed by this method. If two different alkyne halides are used, then it leads to formation of mixture of alkenes which is difficult to purify. And separate. What do I mean by this particular remark is that if you have CH3Br plus, let us suppose that we have CH2Br and I'm reacting these two with sodium metal. Okay. So there will be a number of product that can be formed here. Okay. There can be a number of product. So it doesn't mean that there is only one CH3Br, there is only one CH3CH2Br and only one sodium metal. Okay. There will be millions of molecule present, more than a million. Okay, even if I take one mole of CH3Br, it will contain 10 to the power 23 molecules of CH3Br. That means some of the CH3Br will be reacting. Okay, I have not written dry ethers in the above reactions. Okay, please write that dry ether. Now you can either make CH3 will be formed. There will be some molecule which will be formed by the reaction of only CH3, CH2, CH, and it will be forming CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Now there will be sometimes reaction between these two and you will be forming CH3, CH2, CH3. Okay. So these are mixtures of molecules. Okay. These are not one alkene. We are getting a number of alkenes here. Plus, we'll get NaBr. Okay. You will get NaBr. And these mixtures, they have very slightly different boiling points. That is why we cannot separate them by distillation or any simple method. Okay. So that is why the purification separation of these alkenes is difficult. I write this down. Let me know if you're done. Done? Yes or no?
So we get CH3, CH2, CH3.
What did you say?
How did we get CH3, CH2, CH3?
Achha. So this CH3 can form CH3 free radical. This can form CH3, CH2 free radical. So this free radical and this free radical can react, no?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.